Well, what made you decide on King Kong for a place like Birmingham?
Well, I thought something figurative and something recognisable would be more appealing.
That monstrosity.
All right. That's something different in a way to look at.
Well, how do you think King Kong is city orientated?
Well, as when you think of King Kong, you think of New York. And as I hadn't really compared Birmingham with New York until I came in on the train this morning, actually. And it did look quite like New York.
Look at. We haven't looked it all over yet. Oh, well, she's
do you think it's the sort of thing we could have in Birmingham, do you?
It's different. That's a bit of life.
Now you lads are up there, what's it all about?
Well, there's a national builder strike on at the moment, in support of 30 paying for 35 hours. Today we've got a demonstration of the building workers. They'll be marching round by here about 20 past 11, half 11. And this is sort of a humorous publicity to give a bit of a humour into a grim situation.
Hey, look.
We have the ladder.
The man in question is King Kong. At one time, the scourge of the silver screen, he then became a figure of art in the centre of Birmingham. Now he's been demoted to selling second-hand cars. The man who bought King Kong is Mr. Mike Shanley. Mike, why have you bought King Kong? He's a bit terrifying. Are you trying to scare your customers into buying cars?
No, I think he'll be a good publicity agent for me, and he'll bring more customers here. He doesn't frighten little children when he was... Well, he didn't frighten little children when he was in the bullring, so he's hardly going to frighten them here. A hurry.
You've paid almost £3,000. Do you think it's a good buy for the money?
I think so. I'm sure he'll bring people here. As you've only got to look at the cars and buses going past. You see the people turning their heads. Everybody looks at it.
Thank you.
Thank you.